my channel Math with Nazia. In this video we are going to learn about fraction. Fraction is a very important part in mathematics. So let's learn what is a fraction. Fraction is nothing a part of a whole. For example, I have a circle and I am going to divide this circle into four equal parts. So this circle is divided into four equal parts. Now let me shade two parts of this. So out of this full circle, the two parts are shaded. So here, how should we write a fraction? Since there are four equal parts, the four number of parts will be written in the denominator, that is the bottom, and the number of parts which is shaded. So we have shaded one part and we have shaded two parts. So we have shaded two parts here. So we will write it as 2 by 4. So total number of parts will be written down and the number of shaded parts will be written up. So whatever number is written above, this is called as a numerator, and the number written down is called as a denominator. Isn't it easy? The number of parts will be written down and the number of shaded parts will be written up. So the numbers written up is called as a numerator and the numbers written down as a denominator. But for a fraction, the whole has to be divided into equal parts. The parts should always be equal. So now let's see another example. I have a square here. So let me divide the square into... Now the square is divided into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I have divided into 8 parts. I will write 8 in the denominator. And now I am going to shade 2 parts here. So this equation will be written as 2 by 8. The total number of parts will be written down and the shaded parts would be written up. Same way, this is called as a numerator and this is the denominator. Isn't it easy? Now, let us learn the types of fraction. We have 6 types of fractions: proper fraction, improper fraction, mixed fraction, like fractions, unlike fraction, and equivalent fraction. So, let's see each part separately. What is a proper fraction? An easy way to remember what is a proper fraction. This is a proper fraction which we have written above. 2 by 4 is a proper fraction. 2 by 8 is a proper fraction. So an easy way to remember a proper fraction is the numerator is always less than the denominator. For a proper fraction, the numerator is less than the denominator. For example, we can write the same example which we have, which is 2 by 4. Always the numerator is smaller than the denominator. For improper fraction, it is the other way around. Here the numerator will be bigger than the denominator. For example, we can write 7 by 5. Here the numerator is bigger and the denominator is smaller. So this is called as a improper fraction. Now let's see what is a mixed fraction. A mixed fraction is nothing but any fraction which is written in the form of 3 by 5. So this is written in the mixed form. We have a whole number here and we have a fraction here. So this is called as a mixed fraction. I will explain you detail each type of fraction in the coming video. I'm just giving a gist of all the types of fraction here. So this is a mixed fraction. Now let's see what is a like fraction. Like fractions are nothing but the two fractions have the same denominator. For example, we have 2 by 4 and 3 by 4. These two are like fractions because the denominators are same. So they are called as a like fractions. Unlike fractions, in the other way, the denominators are different. For example, we can give it as 1 by 2, 1 by 3. Here the denominators are different, so they are called as a like fractions. Equivalent fractions are nothing but whenever we solve the fraction to the lowest form, they are equal. So 4 by 6 is equal to 2 by 3. You can also tell it as 2 by 4 is equal to 1 by 2. So these are equivalent fraction. So here we have learnt 6 types of fraction. So we have 6 type of fractions. So one is a proper fraction, where numerator is lesser than the denominator. Then we have improper fraction, where numerator is greater than the denominator. We have mixed fraction. We have like fractions. In like fractions, the denominators are same. In unlike fractions, the denominators are different. And then we have learned the last fraction, which is an equivalent fraction. Equivalent fractions are two fractions are equal when they are in their lowest form. So isn't it easy? If you have any queries regarding this, please comment down in the comment section. And for more tips and tricks, do like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.